MLB The Show is your home for postseason baseball. It's Game 3 of the National League Division Series between the LA Dodgers and the Cincinnati Reds. Again, everyone, Matt Vaskirjian. Welcome to our special postseason coverage of Baseball on the Show. With me is Mark DeRosa and Dan Plesac. And Dan, lots to talk about here as we get ready for Game 3.
It's been a good series so far as these two teams have split the first two games. So essentially, this makes this a three-game series. That means this game is huge. It's a lot easier playing knowing you're one win away from moving on as opposed to one loss from packing it up and heading home.
All right, the stage is set. The starters get their final tosses in out in the bullpen, and we've got a good one in store for you, folks. Play-by-play is coming up next. Series. What's your take on him, Dan?
Hey, man, we're going to get a chance to look at a good veteran pitcher here. This guy's been around the block a few times, but one of the things he does, he still competes at a high level, and he's never stopped trying to learn how to be a good pitcher.
Here's Mookie Betts, and we are ready for some daytime baseball.
Mookie Betts for the Dodgers. The right field, Mookie Betts.
Infield in the overshift here. Now the pitch. And a swing and a miss as Game 3 begins with a first pitch strike. Joey Wendell digs in now. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first.
There you go. For the red.
Now here it comes.
The right fielder.
Back up the middle and in for a base hit. So it's a leadoff base hit, and it makes for a good start to the inning for Cincinnati.
Hey, this game's starting off exactly the way they want it to. Leadoff single in the bottom of the first. After their pitcher went out there and threw a donut on the board, boys are flying around.
In now, Nick Senzel, as Kershaw will get the upper hand here with strike one. Swing and a liner, and that finds the outfield grass for a base hit, and that runner will hold up at second with two aboard. Now first two batters
find a sweet spot, barrel up perfectly. These fans have to be excited. Middle of the order coming to the plate now. After those first two ABs, this could be a laser show.
To the plate now, Jacob Davis, as Kershaw will get the upper hand here with strike one. He's ready. Here's the 0-1. And he fouls this one off.
You can definitely tell with that foul off right there that he's picking up spin on this pitcher's off-speed stuff. Maybe expect a fastball on this next one.
Nothing in two count and the pitch. Lofted in the air out toward right center. Betts giving chase. He makes the play, runner tags and hits for third. The tag, and they got him at third. It's a double play. Out. So now,
leading off for the Reds.
Tyler Stevenson is up off the bench as he'll be asked to get something started in the home half of the seventh. First pitch on its way. Fouled away. The windup and the 0-1. Swing and a liner. And that's going to be a base hit, so it's a pinch hit single here to kick off the home half of the seventh.
I know the score's out of hand right here, but I've never met a big league ball player that's going to give away an at-bat in any game ever. Nice piece of hitting right there, staying within yourself and grabbing you a knock.
Tyler Naquin will come on to pinch hit now with a runner at first and nobody out.
Tyler.
Set and the pitch. Slowly hit to first. I don't think they can get two. One there. And that didn't work out too well as the pinch hitter comes on to bounce into a double play.
That's good athleticism here by the pitcher getting off the mound. He gets the ball to first and then hustles his way over to the bag to help him wrap up the tough 3-6-1 double play.
Pollock is there and it's a very quick inning as the side is retired. Takes just four pitches to set down the Reds. They're down nine. It's 10-1. Tyler Stevenson will stay in the ballgame, taking over the catching duties behind the plate.
Tyler Stevenson.
Sal Romano comes on to pitch now, hoping for better results. Ready to go for the last half of the inning. And at the plate will be the speedy outfielder, Nick Senzel.
Hey, this is where you go up there and you just focus on doing your job. Turn the scoreboard off in your head. I know you're down a lot, but you have to have one quality at bat followed by another quality at bat. Don't give any outs away. No ABs go unnoticed right here.
And the throw to first is in time. One gone.
Up next,
ready now for Cincinnati. Jacob Davis bounced out last time up. Wheels and deals. Here's the first pitch. Into the windup. Here comes the 0-1. Swing and a flare down the line. In there, a base hit. Throwing to second. And he had two on his mind, and that's what he'll get as he's in at second base with a one-out double.
Yeah, some guys have the ability to rise to the occasion, while some guys shrink away when it matters the most. Well, this guy is a gamer. He's been on fire since the postseason started, and after that hit, it looks like he doesn't plan on stopping anytime soon.
Up next is Fernando Tatis Jr. And he'll quickly send a line drive to center field. That's in there. Base hit. And they won't risk it at third, so they're at the corners now with only one away.
Hey, guys, I understand it right there. The third base coach has got to hold them up. They're down by a lot of runs right now. No reason to risk getting a guy thrown out at home in this situation.
Nick Castellanos now, as Kershaw will get the upper hand here with strike one. So far, 2-for-3 in this one. This one's down to third. Turner has it. There's one. On to first, it's a double play as their woes continue. The inning is... Trinan, the 6'5 right-hander, takes over on the mound. Next up will be Kyle Farmer, starting things for his side in the ninth as they face the improbable odds of trying to come back in this one.
Yeah, not a lot of hope for them at this point. These guys know these bats still count, at least for their own stats. You can't mill in your chances as a professional.
Digging in will be Aristides Aquino, flew out last time up. First pitch of the AB on its way. Hit on the ground to third. Turner's got it on the first, and now the Reds are down to their final out here. Now to bat, Tyler Stevenson. He singled first time up. From the stretch, fouled off. Ready with the nothing in one pitch. Hit back up the middle. Reined in. And the throw pulls him off the base, and the inning's gonna continue.
Well, that's always the danger when you've got a lead that's this big. You know there's not a lot of doubt about the outcome of the game, so you lose focus a little bit in the field. And sometimes as a player, you try to trick yourself into playing like it's a close game so you stay sharp.
Jesse Winker will grab a bat and hit for the pitcher here.
Number 33, Jesse Winker.
First pitch coming, here it is. High and deep to right center. Back goes Betts, still going back. Gone! So it's a two-run shot to right center, but they're going to need a few more here as they're still well behind.
Yeah, all things considered, it's been a day to forget for them. So this homer will be a welcome to everyone in that dugout. Maybe this gives them a little momentum going into the next game.
The right fielder, Joey.
And that'll bring up Joey Wendell. And this ball swung on and hit to center field, and this should do it. And he'll squeeze this one for the final out, and the Dodgers are going to take home field advantage right back. They win game three to go up 2-1 as this one is over.
If you want to know what this game was decided, that's easy. Look no further than the seventh inning. That big rally and the crooked number on the scoreboard proved to be all the difference.
Well, this one pretty much over before it started as we give you a final look at the line score here and what turned out to be a blowout victory.
You're gonna be happy.